Hey guys, it's Kelly. Hey, I'm gonna try and get through a tutorial. I think I'll have to do voiceovers and speed up some of it. I'm not sure, but this tutorial is how you make these paper bag pocket buckets. It's more like a bucket, I don't know. But it's kind of like a gift bag. Originally I called it a Tussie Mussie because that's kind of what it reminds me of. Like a Sasquatch Tussie Mussie. But I'm gonna show you guys how to construct this. And I'll do the construction part of it. And then I'll probably have to do a voiceover and kind of speed up how you decorate it. Just with some ideas and inspiration for decorating, because I don't know how I'm gonna do this one. I really don't. I just picked some paper and I'm gonna go with a Halloween theme. So here we go. So first I wanna tell you the kind of bags that you'll need here, okay? Now, the one that I just showed you, I used just plain lunch bags that I got from Target, and these are okay, but the difference is a lot of you that have used celebrated bags, which are these, the difference is pretty big between them. But what you'll find with regular like sack lunch paper bags, they're not even. You see how uneven this is? I can make a shadow maybe. But it's just uneven the way it's cut. Now at the end, it probably won't matter, okay? Because when you open it like this, it's okay, but that's gonna mess with your measurements. So you'd have to measure it through the whole process, and your measurements will be a little off. So you can definitely use these. There's not a darn thing wrong with it. I used it and it came out really nice. I thought it did. And you can use these, but for this tutorial, I'm going to go ahead and use a celebrated bag. I do have a lot of them, and these I like to use for the things I have going on at the school with the kids. So, but just to keep it nice and tidy and clean, I'm going to use a celebrated bag, because the difference is all of these celebrated bags, they are dead on even, and they're just a better quality paper too. They're a lot thicker, and considering that this is going to have going to hold things with a little bit of weight to it, I think it's important to use the celebrated bags. Again, not required. I would recommend it, depending on what you're going to put in it, you know. So here's my celebrated bag. And some of the things that you're going to need to do this, just so if you can get ready and then pause it if you'd like. You're going to need your bag. You're going to need to choose the kind of paper that you're going to use. And I just chose some really cute Halloween paper that I got from Nurse Tara 04. She was destashing, and this is one of the stacks that I bought from her. So it's super cute, really cute paper. So very Halloween-y. So that's what I'm gonna use. You're also gonna need, I always recommend score tape, guys. I've been through a lot of adhesives. This is the best. It's just the best one I found. You're gonna pay a little bit more for it, but darn it if it doesn't stick and stay put. It's good tape. If you don't have that, it's okay. You can use the red sticky tape. You can use liquid glue if you'd like. I don't recommend it. It just gets kind of messy. But, you know, sometimes we don't have a choice. So it'll work with liquid glue, okay? And then you can also use ATG or your snail, whatever. Just try and get the best kind of glue that you can so that it'll stay put. And all you need, I'm showing you both, sorry. All you need is the quarter inch. That's more than enough. Okay? So you need that. Depending on the bag, you might want to get some distress ink too, because you might want to do the edges. I'm using a black bag, and that's exactly what I would have distressed it with. So I'm gonna save my time, and I won't have to ink it because my bag is already black. Okay, so yeah. So let's go through some measurements. So you're gonna need your cutter. And you might want to use a ruler. You'll absolutely need a ruler because you always want to measure twice, cut once. And you'll probably need more, and we'll go as we go. You can pause it and go, oh wait, I gotta grab that. Kelly, you didn't tell me. I'm not the best tutorial person. But okay, so let me show you. So this bag that I'm using, it's the 3 pound paper sack by Celebrate It. And you can do this with any size you want, guys, but if you want to follow along and you're like, give me exact measurements, darn it, here you go. So this one measures top to bottom, full length, 8 and 15/16, okay? And the paper that we're going to have to cut here You're going to need a piece that is 3.5 by 4.5, and that's going to cover this section here, okay? You're going to need a piece that is 4.5 this way by 2 5/8 that way, okay? And then you're going to need two pieces for your gusset area to reinforce it. And those pieces are going to be 2 5/8 this way and 2 inches from top to bottom. Okay? So that's the paper that those are the measurements that we're gonna need. And we'll go through it again because I'm going to have to cut them, and I'll just cut them with you, okay? I don't know where I'm going to put things. I really don't. I just picked out some paper that I thought was cute. And I think I'll just, it might not turn out like perfect the way I want it to, but that's going to be okay. Now, I gave you those measurements if you're just going to use one sheet of paper, but I think I'm going to double my paper up here because I'm kind of liking how that's looking. I'm liking how that's looking. So it's 3.5 here by 4.5. So I'm just going to cut this piece, my matted piece. And I want the pattern. This is where it's important to get your measurements right, because if you've got patterned paper, you know, that you want to display a certain way, you got to cut it right. Otherwise, you're going to mess it up. So I need 4.5 this way and 3.5 that way. So let's hope I do this. I don't know how many times I've messed this up, guys. Hopefully you have too, so I don't feel all alone. Three and a half that way. Nice. You guys probably didn't see me do that. And then 4.5 this way. Okay. So there's my piece that's going to go there. And those measurements are set to accommodate for this pocket coming up like that, okay? Because you don't need to go all the way down. There's no reason to waste paper. You just need to go just a little bit past that pocket, okay? So I hope you guys can see that. And the way my bag is going, no, I'm going to leave it just the way it is. So 4.5 by 3.5. Okay, so there's my first piece. Then I need 4.5 by 2 5/8. And let's see, what will I put down here? I think I'm gonna put this right up here. But I don't want it to be covered. So that's gonna go there. Maybe I'll do polka dots, because I'll put embellishments down here. Why not? So, and the polka dots don't matter, so I need 4.5 this way and 2 5/8 that way. Okay? Let me get my cut on. I'm gonna cut that all the way because I'll probably use it. So 4.5 that way and 2 5/8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm terrible with measuring. Achoo, excuse me. There we go. Okay, so that's gonna go right there. I like it. And that'll go like that. I'm not sure about this. Might be too much. So just in case, so I have options, I'm going to cut 4.5 by 2 5/8 in this too. Because I got the paper to use it. You guys, if you're hoarding your paper, shame on you. Shame. We all do it. We all do it. But yeah, I mean, you bought it to use it and to make something beautiful with it. So just cut it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 5/8. Whoops, measure twice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. I'm not sure which one I'll like better, so we'll see. And then on the back, I need 5 5/8, 4 1/2. And let's see. I have these scraps from when I bought this from Tara. And I bet I can use one of these for back here. Nope. Unless I zigzag it. You know what? I can do that. That's no big deal. Okay. Yeah, I think I'll do that. And I might decide to mat it with something else. We'll see. So again, 4 1/2 by 5 5/8. So I'm going to do this way. Right? Right. Double check. Yes. 5 5/8. I know, I take long, sorry guys, but take a long time to cut, but I found, I'll use that strip for something, but I found that the longer I take the cut, the better my chances are that I don't jack it up. And I double check and double check, because you know, a lot of you guys have kids, you get distracted, you come back, you're like, where was I? What? Oh, and then you think you know. Then you cut it and you're like, son of a biscuit. I messed it up. Thought I was going to swear, didn't you? Okay. See, that's okay to turn that zigzaggy like that. Okay. So now I've got all my big cuts done. I didn't cut the side yet, and I'm just going to wait for that. Because I don't know what paper I'm going to use for that. I want to see how it looks first. But I am going to ink these papers. Okay. I'm going to ink the edges, and I am going to use black soot. And I'm going to do it off screen because when I go like this, my little pieces break off and they get on my workstation. Then everything gets little black dirt marks on it, ink marks on it. So I'm going to ink them and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I'm back. So I should scoot over a little bit. I'm just famous for getting out of screen. So I got my guys inked here. Okay, and we want to put our paper down here before we glue our pocket down. So I need to figure out how I'm going to, I would like the Halloween to show. So I think I'm going to cut it at full. Yeah, I'm just eyeballing this, guys. And you can do it however you guys want. You know, with however you're going to embellish it. Hold on to that. I'm just using up the scraps that I have. So, So that's why I'm kind of rolling with it here. So that's going to go right about there. And that will come up right about there. I don't know about that, guys. I don't think I like that. We'll see. If I jack it up, then I'll just have to cut another piece. Maybe I'll do that. And it looks like a continuation. I think it will. I think I like that. Okay. I'm going to ink this really quick. And I went off and I thought I was going to do it this way, but I wound up liking how it looks better like this. just a little shadow there. And then where's my other piece? Might as well ink that too. There we go. Where was I? Okay. So I liked it butted right up against there. So here, to do this, I'm just going to use my ATG gun. I don't need to use the score tape for this part because this is just going to get stuck down and not really get pulled on. Okay. I like it just like that. And you guys are going to need your bone folder too, because this is going to change and give a little bit after you give it a really good varnishing. Just give it a really good crease. Okay, make sure it's nice and flat. And then I want to make sure that I get this on there where I want it. I want it right about there. Okay. So I'm going to use my pencil and mark it at the bottom where it's going to be covered up. Again, if you don't have an ATG or anything like that, you can just use liquid glue if you'd like. Heck, you can use double-sided tape if you want. Use Elmer's glue if you want. You don't have to have all this stuff to make things that are pretty. So I'm going to line it up right there. I lined it. Oh yeah, hello. Okay. Goes down like that. I'm okay if it's not exactly perfect. Now right here is where you're going to need your score tape, not half, just a little strip. You're only going to put it right here, guys. Don't put it here or you're going to close your pocket. I can't tell you how many times I've closed my pockets and had to rip them open and cover them up because I just completely jacked it up. So just put your score tape on there. One strip there. And one strip there. As close to the edge as you can get it without going over. Okay. Peel that off. Peel that off and sticker down. Don't be scared, just do it. I'm a little off the edge there, but you know what? I don't care. I'm going with it. I'm not sure what I'm doing back here, but I know that I'm going to use this piece since I cut it, so I'm just going to glue that down. Get the easy stuff out of the way. You love that when your ATG does that. The glue is like suspended Like a ghost is holding it up or something. There's my little ink balls that I was talking about. You hear my kids singing. My Austin. He is 10. And he is so into Minecraft, it's not even funny. He is just like crazy addicted to it. And he watches these YouTube videos with these songs. And he walks around the house singing them all the time. It's so funny. All right, hold on, he's singing too loud, hold on. That was funny. He's so silly. Okay. All right. So let's glue this part down. Now, if you decided that you did not want to make like the bucket deal and you just wanted to make like a card, paper bag card, which is what inspired this, of course. I just needed a little bit more space in there to put stuff for the gifts that I'm giving to the person that's getting this. But if you wanted to just stop here, you know, you don't have to make the big pocket deal. I'm trying to line it up with the other paper. There we go. You don't have to make, make the bucket part of it. You know, you definitely not require, but depends on what you're giving. If you're just gonna give a gift certificate or something like that, this would be great. This would be perfect. Who doesn't love making these? It's like instant beautiful. Love it. Whee. Okay. So see, this would just be like a card, and you could put like a tag right in there, embellish it however you would like, and then you can put all kinds of other stuff right inside there and be done with it. And that's gorgeous how you make those cards. And there's all kinds of videos out there of people doing that. And I love it. I love their videos because that's what inspired me to make what I made. But now, since this is a tutorial on how to make the bucket part of it, we are going to do that. So, the measurements that you need is 2 5/8 that way and 2 inches that way. Now, the paper that I'm going to use for this, I'm not sure. This is like basically already my size. It might make sense just to use that. So I might not be right on with my 2 5/8. Let's see where I'm at. Oh, I am right at 2 5/8. Okay, so measure your paper. So that is 2 5/8 this way, perfect. And now I need to cut it down to 2 inches. And this one piece will get me both sides, so. I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna go for it. I'm just cutting it. If I'm out of screen, guys, I'm just cutting it to size that I need. That's all. Hold on. Now I just turn it by eights. So I need 2. Oh gosh, I hope I don't mess that up. I'm having brain flatulent moments today, like no tomorrow. Today, like no tomorrow, that's kind of funny. Ta-da. Okay, there we go. So now we've got our two pieces, And I don't like the white core showing. I don't like that. So I'm going to ink it. This is how I usually do it. And since there's nothing underneath me and I'm going to clean it up, I'll just do it like that real fast. This glittery part on this paper resists it anyway, so I don't need to push it onto the paper so much. Plus, it's already black. So I'm just getting rid of the white core look. I don't like that. Looks unfinished. Okay. See, I got all my little pieces because my sponge is just getting worn out, but it's not at a point where I need to replace it. So I keep using it. Foam pieces. Put that up there. Let me dry that off so my paper doesn't stick to it. Okay, so now here we are. And these pieces are going to go right here like so. Okay. That's great. But now what we need to do is find our center on each piece, okay? The reason why we need to find our center is because I like to put the hole to hold the ribbon. I'll show you on this one. I don't want it to be too far up there. I don't want it to be too far down here. So finding your center in this measured piece is like the perfect variable there to where it doesn't, whatever you put in there isn't going to weigh it down. So much to where it's going to pull right out the top. It's still got enough give there, and plus the eyelet really helps too. And by the way, in your supplies, you're going to need two eyelets. yeah, I knew I would forget something. So let me find some Halloween-y eyelets. Well, I'm using black and white. I don't think I have any orange. Gun fell. So, you know what? I'll just use two white. And that'll work out just fine. What do I have over here? No. So, that's what we'll go with. So, pause me and go get yourself two eyelets. And your hole puncher, too. You're going to need that. Your big, what is it called? I can never remember. Your big bite? Crocodile. Get your crocodile. Okay? You need that. Alrighty, I had two pieces of paper, and now I just have one. There it is. So we're gonna find our center. And we use our ruler to find our center. I'm giving you time to go get your eyelets. You don't have to find it right now, but oh, for crying out loud, I'm all butterfingers. That worked out. I'm being really anal about this, guys. If you want to eyeball it, for crying out loud, eyeball it. But a lot of people don't know how to find their center. on things, and you just use the, this is the only way I know how to find my center, guys, my like true center or something. You just put the zero on there and have equal sides on both sides. If you've never known how to find center, this is how you do it. You put your paper down, okay? And there's your zero. And you just make sure that you have equal sides. See, it goes out this way from the zero to one, out this way to one. And you just make sure you're equal on both sides, and then you mark it. I like to draw a line. I'm going to glue that down so it doesn't matter. So that's my center point. And I could, you know, try and copy it right there, but I'm not going to. Yeah, maybe I will. Because this is the exact same measurement. I'm lining it up with these lines on my score pal, my mat, score pal cutting mat, and then I can line my ruler up with the lines on each one, because I am a straight line kind of girl. How I roll in straight lines. Okay, now I got my center. Let's punch that bad boy. I'm gonna punch a hole in it. And I recommend using the bigger eyelets, not the 1/8, 3/16. So just punch your hole. Ooh, I got a little excited. And punch your hole. Okay. Now I found the easiest way to do it on here is to put it on where I want to, where I like it. Okay, like that. That's about where I'm going to glue it. Take your pencil. I'm using black, so I'm going to use white. And mark it. Okay, there you go. That's, you know, that's where you're going to punch it. Now, depending on the bag that you use, make sure that you use the right, because sometimes these two pieces might be a little off, especially if you're using one of the cheaper bags. So use the different, you know, one. I know I have the exact same size on each side, but something you might want to check. It'll be off a little bit from the other side, and that's okay. I'm not going to be that crazy anal about it. Oof. There we go. So now I know where to punch it there. So let's do that. Grab your thingamajigger bobber. And see what's so cool about this paper is it'll stay rigid for me while I get my act together. The other one did not. It was very flimsy. There it goes. This guy doesn't want to stay, so I'm going to hold it like that. And there it goes. Now my holes are in there. Again, guys, eyeballing it is okay. It's all right. But measurements is what a lot of people who ask for tutorials are interested in, so that's what I go with. Okay? So you see, now my holes line up nice and pretty. So now we'll glue it down. Whatever adhesive you like. Make sure my video is still videoing. I'm gonna stop it and come right back. Here I am. I found if I don't do that, if my videos go a little bit long, I'll be like sitting here going along talking to you guys. And hello, I'm not even recording. Hello. Okay, to get this lined up, perfectly can be a little tricky. So what I found that I use is I have this little, it's for my Garmin, but I never use this on my Garmin. I just use my finger. But if I use a stylus, you can use anything, just some point that will go through like that and kind of guide me onto the hole. This could be really questionable. Okay, guide you right on, and up, stick it down. Okay, I found that helps me. Otherwise, I'm off and I'm wonky and I'm out. You could just stick it on and just eyeball it. You know, that would be way easier. But for those, you know, make those choices for yourself. But for those anal people, I found I'm pretty darn anal. Never knew it until I started scrapping, crafting, whatever. Never really knew how anal I was until I watched a couple of my own videos. I was like, seriously, Kelly? Seriously? Are you that anal? Yep. Yes. Yes, I am. Hello, my name's Kelly, and I'm anal. All right. Maneuver your bag. Get your little thing in there to help guide you down. I have very unsteady hands, so I am perfectly okay with... Oh, look what I did. I'm off. Oh, gosh, just be done with it. There. Okay. So there it is. It could be a house, too. Look, it's a haunted house. Holy cow. I just came up with a whole nother thing. And then you put a roof on this side. I'll be making that next. Yep, absolutely. And I'll be putting a door here. Or maybe, I don't know. But yeah, it's a birdhouse. A haunted house. You can make a whole bunch of houses with all different kinds of bags. Anyway, that's not what this tutorial is about, is it? So anyway. But yeah. I'm really stuck on that now. I'm going to make houses. See all the things we can come up with. And now you need to put in your eyelets. No big deal. Slap it on there. Now, guys, I am not a professional. I never know which one of these to use. I used this one last night and it worked, so that's the one I'm sticking with. But I always feel so weird about it because I don't know which one is right and which one you're supposed to use and blah, blah, blah. So I usually screw up eyelets. But I have a lot of them. I'm so gonna screw that up. I can feel it. It's coming. Oops. I'm just gonna do it. Yep, I went for it. Worked out. Where'd my other eyelet go? There it is. So there we go. Get your eyelet in there. If you guys don't have like one of these crocodile tooth things, you can try to, there's those reinforcers where you can just, glue it on. I think Tim Holtz has some of those reinforcers, like for tags. You could try to use that. I just recommend that you reinforce it somehow because the paper itself is just going to get worn and it might break after a while. So I think eyelets are the best way to go, but if you don't have that and you don't have a means to close the eyelets like what I'm showing you here. If you don't have that available to you, you can still get it done and just use a couple of those reinforcers there. Okay? So there it is. That's how you construct it. Then you choose your ribbon and or rope, whatever you want to use. I have no idea what I'm going to use for this one. But I'll record that and do a quick voiceover for that part of the tutorial so you guys can see how I finish this up. But I'm really liking it. I think it's super cute, very Halloween-y, and I hope you guys like it too. But look at all the room that I have in there. Like, I could fit two fists in there. That's a whole lot of candy. All right, cool. Thank you, and I'll be back with the sped-up version of how I make this pretty. Hey, guys. I made a boo-boo. I'm going to insert this at the end before I let go to embellish it. As you can see, it's all done. I'll go through that later. What I forgot to tell you guys is that we needed to reinforce the insides of this too. So when we did these two pieces, when we cut these two pieces for the side, we needed four of them, not two. It's only the second time I made this, and I'm doing a tutorial. I should have made more first, but just trying to get it out there quick. So make four of those, put them together, find the center of all of them, put them together, or just find the center on that one, and then put this one in there and draw a circle, like mark it and punch it, okay? So then put your eyelet in. So I'll put some comments in the video when I do it through Movie Maker that says, whoa, 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 this isn't right. Stay tuned, there'll be more to come. But yeah, so, and it does make a big difference to have both the inside and reinforcer and the outside, because I embellished this whole thing without it, and it was flimsier. I'm pushing it now, but it was starting to buckle on me. So these do make a big difference. So make sure that you make four of those, not just two, like I just said. And then I'll do another video at the end and go through the embellishments, because my battery died and you didn't get to see everything. All right, thanks. Okay, guys. So we didn't catch all of it, but we got some of it. So there are some of the gate pieces and just some of the things that I've set up that I knew I was going to use. And that is how that flower started. It's just the ruffled ribbon. And I hot glued it. And I think I go off screen for a while on this. I keep doing that, and it's so hard to tell. I just need to record like half of my body when I'm recording. But sometimes I'm in my jammies. I don't want to do that. But I'm just hot gluing it and just rolling it like together, just kind of making a circle with the ribbon. And I've never really made a whole lot of flowers myself, except for just gluing, you know, flowers together, like prima flowers and paper flowers and things like that. But starting to get into it. So you guys have probably seen this a lot with the ruffled ribbon, but it's super quick, fast flower that you make yourself. I think it's really cool, and I got that ribbon from Fiona. So there it is, and then I just have an orange button right there in the center, and there's some thread, you know, just embroidery thread right there, the black thread, and I just put it through the button and tied a bow, and on a black flower and then on a white flower. And then I inked the edges of the white flower with black soot and just glued it all together, and that was my flower center. So, and then I like to put a felt bottom on my flowers at the bottom. It just looks neater and they stay glued down better. It gives it a nice even bottom. And that's just a piece of white felt. So just cut it out and glue it on. And my battery was dying in the last few hints here, so we won't get very far with it, but I just want to show you what, at least what I had, and then I'll explain all the embellishments that I got at the end. Putting the flower one up looking cute, and there's the tulle. It's the black and orange tulle, and I'm just kind of twisting it. And then I twisted the black with the white ribbon around it. I didn't glue it down, it's all loose. And then I glued it so it would stay put, and then it made it hard to get it through the eyelet. So keep that in mind. You gotta stick it through the eyelet, and then you need the knot in there after you put it through the eyelets. Yeah. I made it work. I cut it and tied another knot. So, but I like that little black ribbon on there. So, and this is the point where my battery started dying, and I barely caught any of this here, so. Get to see my stamp set and that Kane Company set right there. And then my battery dies. So thanks, guys. Okay, guys, so my battery died and we missed a lot. So I'm just going to go over how I embellished it really quick. So I think you guys caught some of this, but not all of it. But so yeah, sorry about that tutorial deal where I forgot to tell you guys about the inside. And I'll tell you now, how I did the inside was I just put a hole in it and I cut the paper up to the hole and just slid it down over it. And I had to make the holes just a little bit bigger because I had glued these big knobby thingies in here. So I just did my hole, cut it, slid it down, and I used liquid glue because the other glue would have been too difficult. So, but I still did it, saved it. Woo! It would have worked without it, but it was just not as sturdy as we needed it. It was buckling on us. So those reinforcement pieces are real important to do this bucket type of paper bag deal. So I went through it, and I think I even say that in the video, like, my battery dies, and then I just keep going along. That's exactly what happened. So what you missed was these gate pieces I punched using this Martha Stewart punch and just some black cardstock, some of the thickest one that I had. And then I just cut it to the size that I wanted. And I glued the top part of the vent, because there's a little, like there's some here, there's like a little black area down there. And I used my half inch score tape and laid a strip of tape down there. And actually two of them. It goes down pretty far, two of them. And And then I slid it down in there and then took off one, slid it down, then took off the other one, because that's kind of tricky to get it down there because it's really sticky tape. So, and it worked out. So that's how I got the fence in there, and the pocket is so good. I put the tape on the top of the fence, okay? And then this part, I think this is where it cut off, and then I tried again and thought it was recording and it wasn't. But this is a chipboard piece from the K&N Company. I got this on clearance for like $2.63 at Hobby Lobby. And it's chalk finish. You can actually write on there with chalk if you want to. But instead I just used my creepy stamp, which I think I caught that on video, and I used this VersaMagic Cloud White chalk ink. So, and it went right on there. And then this is a charm that I have, goes perfectly with this, and a little green Halloween brad that goes through the chipboard, and then I just glued it down. These are already stuck. They're like running it through Xyron type of sticky. And it wasn't sticking down very well, so I had to put some glue behind it to hold it down. So, and you guys saw how I did that flower. I really like how that turned out. And then these tags, this is from last year's Martha Stewart mat pad. I think that's where I got that. Huh. I'm pretty sure that's where I got that from. But I just matted it on black cardstock and made eyes on the birds on both sides. Okay, and then swiped it with some black paint. I don't know if you could see that, but I just felt like it needed that. So it's just a little tag that can go right in there like that. And this is just some tulle and an eyelet. And this is from last year's Halloween leftovers. And I just used my gel pen and made it kind of glittery in his eyes in there. And that tag goes in there. And then this is cut from the paper line that I used, the Haunted Hallows, Teresa Collins. And I just stuck that right in there because it's super cute. Okay? And then this is just twisted tulle, orange and black, and then I twisted this really fine ribbon around it because it wasn't quite poppy enough for me with just the orange and black. It needed something, and I like how that turned out with the ribbon. I think it complements it really well. So, and then on the back, there's the fence again, and I used it as a pocket. And this is a sticker pack from last year's Martha Stewart Halloween collection. So it's a sticker. I had to add my own adhesive because the stickers never stay. So I just stuck that on the bottom part of my fence and then glued it down there with just the quarter inch tape right here, down there, and right there, and then left my pocket so I could put some stuff in there. And then I cut this from the collection. It's just a sheet with all these words, and I cut it right out of there. So that's how that worked out. I know I'm missing something. Not the best tutorial, guys, but I'm going to piece it together and make it work somehow. So if you have questions, let me know. And I'll probably try and do another one I might do another Halloween one because I really like, this was fun. It was a lot of fun to make, so. Hope you guys like it, and thank you for watching. Sorry I had some boo-boos in there, but I think we got through it. So let me know if you have any questions. Thanks, guys. Bye.